Welcome students. Here we will go for one of the typical IC, that is CD4046, which is a digital phase lock loop IC. First of all, we will take a review of the PLL fundamentals. PLL stands for phase lock loop. Analog as well as digital phase lock loop ICs are available. The phase lock loop consist of mainly three blocks. First one is the phase detector, which is also called as phase comparator or phase discriminator. Second is the low pass filter, and third one is the voltage controlled oscillator. The input to the phase detector will be the input one, which we are going to apply externally, having a voltage Vi and a frequency of Fi. The second input to the phase detector will be obtained from the output of the VCO, that is the V oscillator and having frequency of F oscillator. The input to the oscillator will be from the output of the low pass filter. The output of phase detector will be proportional to the phase difference between the two inputs, which is acting as an input to the low pass filter. The steady state characteristics of the basic PLL is as shown in the diagram, where it shows the variation of oscillator frequency at the output of the VCO against the input signal frequency, that is Fi, variation. As per the diagram, the two range of frequencies of the input signal frequencies are highly important, which are known as the capture range and the lock range. First, the lock range. The range of frequencies from Fi is equal to F minimum to F maximum, where the locked PLL remains in the locked condition, is called as the lock range of the PLL, which is equal to twice of FL. Means the loop is already in the lock condition and it will retain its lock state. If the PLL is initially locked and Fi becomes smaller than F minimum, or if it exceeds F maximum, the PLL will no longer able to keep the status of the lock condition and the PLL becomes unlocked. That is, the output of VCO, that is F oscillator, is not equal to the input frequency. When the PLL is unlocked, the VCO will oscillate at the frequency FO, which is called as the center frequency or the free running frequency of VCO. Capture range. The lock can be established again if the incoming signal frequency Fi gets close enough to the free running frequency. The range of frequencies Fi is equal to FO minus FC to Fi is equal to FO plus FC, such that initially unlocked PLL becomes locked, is called as the capture range of the PLL. Twice of FC is called as the capture range. Now we will come to the IC CD4046, which is a CMOS IC and a micropower phase lock loop IC. First of all, we will go for the features of the IC. Very low power consumption, typically 70 microwatt at VCO center frequency of 10 kHz and the supply voltage of 5 volt. Operating frequency range up to 1.4 MHz typically at supply voltage of 10 volt, and R1, which is a VCO frequency determining component, equal to 5 kilo ohms. Low frequency temperature drift, which is equal to 0.04% per degree Celsius, at supply voltage of 10 volt. In the IC, we are having a choice of two phase comparators. First is the exclusive OR gate, or you may say the XOR gate, and second, it is the edge controlled memory network with phase pulse output for the locked output condition. The VCO is having very high linearity, which is less than 1% typically at operating supply voltage of 10 volt. Remember, the linearity is expressed in terms of non-linearity. VCO inhibit control for on-off keying and ultra-low standby power consumption. So when we have to minimize the power consumption, this pin can be useful. A source follower output of VCO control input for eliminating the loading effect, and it is available on the demodulator output pin. Internal Zener diode is available, which will assist the supply regulation. 100% tested for quiescent current at 20 volt supply voltage. The three parametric ratings are available when the IC is operated at 5 volt, 10 volt and 15 volt. A list of applications of the IC. First one, FM demodulator and modulator. Second, frequency synthesis and multiplication. Third, frequency discriminator. Fourth, data synchronization. Fifth, only the VCO can be useful as voltage to frequency converter. Sixth one, tone decoding. Seventh, FSK modems. And eighth one will be the signal conditioning purpose. First of all, we will come to the pinout of the IC CD4046B. It is a 16 pin IC available in DIP. The pin number 1 is phase pulses. It is the output available when we are going to use the phase comparator second, and when it will get locked, it will give the output as in terms of the acknowledgement at pin number 1. Pin number 2 and pin number 13. These two are phase comparator 1 and phase comparator 2 output pins. Pin number 3 is the comparator input. Pin number 4, the VCO output is available. Pin number 5, that is the inhibit pin for minimization of the power consumption. This pin is useful. Pin numbers 6, 7 and pin number 11 and 12. These four pins are useful with the VCO. Between pin numbers 6 and 7, we have to connect a VCO timing capacitor. Pin number 11, we have to connect R1 register to VSS, that is R1 pin number 11 to ground. This register will determine the VCO frequency along with the capacitor C1. If we don't want a frequency offset, then from pin number 12, we have to connect a register R2 to VSS. Pin number 8 and pin number 16, these are the supply pins. Pin number 8 is VSS, or you may say ground pin. Pin number 16 is a VDD, that is the supply voltage. Pin number 9 is the VCO input pin, because the low pass filter is the external one and the output of low pass filter needs to be connected at pin number 9 to the VCO. Pin number 10 will be the demodulator output pin. Pin number 14 will be the input pin, which is required to connect the external signal input. As we have seen in the features, at pin number 15, the internal Zener diode is present for supply regulation. This will show you the PLL block diagram in much detail, where all the different internal blocks are present, as per their functionality, the various pins available, and externally we are having a low pass filter consisting of the two components, that is a simple passive low pass filter R3 and a capacitor C2. Now the two phase comparators are connected to a single low pass filter. At a time, one phase comparator we have to use. Again, here you have to observe how the connection from VCO out to comparator input is made. Either you may directly connect the VCO output as comparator input, or you may insert a divide by N network, which is useful for the application like frequency multiplier. VCO section. The two components R1 and C1 will determine the frequency range, and R2 is used for frequency offset. The VCO is having very high input impedance, typically 10^12 ohms. With no signal input connected to the IC, or if we may say only noise is present, the phase comparator 1, which is an XOR gate, the voltage will be available equal to VDD by 2, and the output of VCO will be a free running frequency FO, or also called as a center frequency. The phase shift may vary between the two inputs of phase comparator from 0 to 180 degree, and at the center frequency it will be equal to 90 degree. The phase comparator 1 can get locked on input signal frequencies which are close to the harmonics of the center frequency FO. The typical selection values for the different registers R1, R2, RS, they should be from 10 kilo ohms to 1 mega ohms. The capacitor C1 should be greater than or equal to 100 picofarad if the IC is operated at 5 volt. That capacitor C1 should be greater than or equal to 50 picofarad when being operated at the voltage greater than or equal to 10 volts. This will show a typical characteristic or a set of characteristics between the center frequency FO and the VCO timing capacitor C1. If you will see, these characteristics have been provided by the manufacturer of the IC for three different register values R1, 10K, 100K and 1 mega ohm. So each value of register will consist of three characteristics, or you may say curves, which are for the different supply voltages. Earlier we have seen that the IC can be operated for three different voltages, that is 5 volt, 10 volt and 15 volt. This will show you the signal waveforms of the phase comparator 1 when it will getting locked at FO, that is the center frequency. So from the first two waveforms, the first is your signal input, second is the VCO output, which is connected to the comparator input. When the phase shift is equal to 90 degree, at that time the input to the VCO will be equal to the output of low pass filter shown in the fourth waveform, and which is average of that will be equal to VDD by 2. The phase comparator output, which is available at terminal number or pin number 2. So that will be the difference between the phases of the two inputs. Now we will go for the phase comparator 1 characteristic low pass filter output. The first characteristic of this type of phase comparator is that it can lock onto input frequencies that are very close to the harmonics of the VCO center frequency. A second characteristic is that the phase angle between the signal and the comparator input varies between 0 degree and 180 degree, which is equal to 90 degrees at the center frequency. So in this way, we can have a plot of the output voltage, that is the V phi, which is a output of the phase detector versus the phase shift. The phase comparator second. The phase comparator second is an edge controlled digital memory network. It consists of four flip-flop stages, a control gating, and a three-state or tri-state output circuit, which consists of the P and N drivers having a common node output. So, as shown in the figure, the tri-state network consists of a PMOS and NMOS, which is having a common output node. When the PMOS and NMOS drivers are on, they will pull the output up to VDD or down to VSS respectively. This type of phase comparator acts only on the positive edge of the signal and comparator inputs. Hence, the duty cycle is not of much importance when we are going to use phase comparator second. The waveforms will show you the states of the phase comparator second for three different regions. The first waveform is of signal input, second is of VCO output, then third waveform will be the phase comparator second output, fourth will be the VCO input, which is obtained from the low pass filter output, and the fifth waveform will show you the phase pulses which are available at pin number 1 of the IC. These waveforms are divided in three regions, first, second, and third. So, we will go for the description in brief of the working when we are going to use phase comparator second. If the input signal frequency is greater than the comparator input, the PMOS will be maintained or for most of the time. If the signal input frequency is less than the comparator input, then NMOS will be maintained on. If the signal frequency is equal to the comparator input frequency, but if my input signal lags in phase, then the NMOS is maintained or for the time corresponding to the phase difference between the two inputs. If the signal frequency and comparator input frequency both are equal, but the input leads in phase, then the PMOS is maintained on for the time corresponding to the phase difference. This will be in operation till both the inputs are equal in frequency, as well as there will be no phase difference present. Subsequently, the capacitor voltage of the low pass filter is adjusted until the signal and comparator inputs are equal in both phase and frequency. At this stable operating point, both the PMOS and NMOS output drivers remains off and the phase comparator output becomes an open circuit. This is the third state and it holds the voltage on the capacitor of the low pass filter constant. Now we will go for the phase comparator comparison in the tabular form in the two slides. The various characteristics and corresponding the comparison between phase comparator 1 and phase comparator 2. The VCO frequency. VCO without offset, So we have not to connect the R2. That's why they have said R2 is equal to infinity ohms. When we will connect R2, we will get the frequency offset. The same will be present for phase comparator 1 and phase comparator 2. When we are not going to connect any input signal, then for phase comparator 1, the VCO in the PLL system adjusts to the center frequency. Whereas the VCO for phase comparator 2 will adjust to the lowest operating frequency, that is F minimum. The third parameter is the lock range, that is twice FL. It is the full VCO frequency range which is determined by R1 and C1. So lock range will be equal to F max minus F min. The next parameter, frequency capture range twice of FC. So when we are going to use phase comparator 1, then we have to go for the notes mentioned in the data sheet. Twice of FC is nearly equal to 1 upon tau 1 into square root of twice 2 pi FL upon tau 1, where tau 1 will be equal to R3 into C2. Similarly, loop filter selection components R3 and C2 are present. In case of phase comparator 2, the lock range is equal to the capture range. Then the next parameter is phase angle between the signal and comparator inputs. As earlier we have seen, for phase comparator 1, it is 90 degrees at the center frequency, approximating 0 degree and 180 degrees at the ends of lock range. Whereas for phase comparator 2, the phase angle between the signal and comparator inputs is always equal to 0 degrees in the lock condition. The next parameter or characteristic, locks on harmonics of the center frequency. So for phase comparator 2, yes, it can lock on the harmonic frequencies, but the phase comparator 2 cannot get locked. The next parameter, signal input noise rejection. It is very high in case of phase comparator 1, whereas in case of phase comparator 2, it is low. Then the next and last parameter will be VCO component selection. So when we have to use the IC, the VCO component selection plays an important role. So according to which phase comparator we are going to use, with or without frequency offset, the design of the VCO component is available. Recall that we have to use for VCO component selection the characteristics which is provided by the manufacturer in the data sheet. That characteristic, or you may say a set of characteristics between the VCO center frequency FO and the VCO timing capacitor C1 for different values of supply voltages as well as the various values of the resistor R1, that is 10 kilo ohm, 100 kilo ohm and 1 mega ohm. Thank you.